Welcome to episode 2 of our Northern Lights vlog with Viking Cruises. Please subscribe to our channel and select the bell to receive notifications of our new content. Thank you. After an overnight in Bergen, Viking Venus was off on her adventure. We capped off a really wonderful sail away with dinner at Manfredi's, the Italian specialty restaurant included in your cruise fare. The next morning, on our first sea day, we crossed into the Arctic Circle and earned our Order of the Blue Nose certificate. The ritual included jumping into a pool of ice-cold water, getting blue frosting on our nose, and downing a welcome shot of aquavit. I got there early and queued to go second to be able to film. Some passengers participated while others watched. It was all great fun.
Of course, cold as ice.
Thank you very much. Proper way to get out? Okay, thank you.
After our Arctic plunge, we warmed up in the winter garden with the best afternoon tea on the Seven Seas. Along with your choice of a wide variety of teas come delicate finger sandwiches, a few sweets, and of course, freshly baked scones with cream and jam. Cream first, of course. Today we are headed to attend a ceremony by a Sami shaman. Today, half of the estimated 80,000 Sami live in northern Norway. The ceremony took place in this lavu, a tent-like structure that is still used today for ceremonies, but also mainly by reindeer herders when in remote portions of Norway.
Hello. Hello. Hi. Is it okay to touch? Yes. Is she a little shy? Maybe
yeah.
Later.
He's just a puppy.
A puppy?
Yeah.
This is my wife, Beate. And this is the helper, Fredrik. And another helper is there, Jonathan. Now we will give you coffee. If you want tea, just tell our fantastic handlers. We will give you tea.
That's good, thank you.
And actually, this is a little bit too big. Normally, lavus are a little bit much smaller. Room for one family or two families. So this is the biggest there is, 100 people's lavu and our kids. I hope they will come down. We like to take care of the culture and the language. That means 50% of the time we're speaking Sami language at home, and the rest English and Norwegian. Norwegian. But because of we have so many guests, and we have even a helper from Switzerland, we speak very much English in our house. So there are some small groups like Ume Sami, Skolte Sami, Pite Sami. So it's 5, 6, 7 languages. But there is another group of language in Norway, in Europe. It's Sami, Finnish, Estonian, Hungarian. It's a Finnish-Ugric group. So Sami language is in the same group as Finnish and Estonian. It's totally different from Norwegian. If we go to the funeral, you change this red with some black. And we take off all the... This is made of antlers bones. And this is made of silver. We take it off for the funeral. And if you go in festivals, then we can harvest some silver, but not expensive, believe me. You can lose it. If you go to the wedding, be careful. You can have a lot of silver, but never more than the bride. Shoes, your shoes. Yes, show it. She has the most perfect shoes I ever seen. It's made of reindeer. That's normal. We use like to do walk with it. It's you see, it's going a little bit more up than this. This is from a supermarket, and this is more correct Sami culture. We like to sing. We call it joik. Joik is the oldest way of singing in Europe. You know, you can sing everything, people, places, animals, spirits. So we're going to start to sing our son. Iskumati, he's 9 years old, and he's like me when I was a boy. He's running around all the time, very speedy. We have problem to make him sit and eat one dinner. He's sitting like this. Therefore his yoik is moving very fast. Hey yo, lolelu, ale yo, lolelu. Hey yo, iskumati. Hey yo, lolelu. Hey yo, stora ganda. Hey yo, lolelu. Hey yo, lolelu, ale yo, lolelu. Hey yo, lolelu, ale yo, lolelu. Hey yo, lole. Hey yo, lole. Hey olole, 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 hey olole. Hey, alone, hey, alone, hey, alone, hey, alone.
Thank you. And what is salmon, lingonberry, and what?
Sour cream.
Sour cream.
My daughter said his name is Spirit. That's it. Okay. Spirit is a good name. And he is the most kindest and calm husky I ever seen. He's so friendly and nice and walking after Beate the whole day. And even and he's big. He's 7 months and he's 30 kilo. And that's too much on the fire.
Yeah, do not.
Yeah, don't.
Thank you.
Do not eat.
Do not eat.
Do not eat.
Do not eat.
Drink? Yes, do not.
The remainder of the ceremony following this scene was considered solemn and had to be honored without the use of electronics. The ceremony involved the beating of the drum and yoiking to ask the spirits for good fortune. The wood chips we were all given earlier were thrown into the fire by each individual. Some Sami believe that the resulting ash rising is a way of communicating with the spirits, and that a strong Northern Lights evening is a sign of spirits' favorable view of such ceremonies. What a wonderful experience this was. Did the spirits see the ash and approve of our ceremony? Upon our return to the ship, from our balcony, we were treated to that very possibility. We hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please consider subscribing to our channel and clicking that thumbs up button. Thank you. In our next episode, we spend 2 days in Alta, Norway. Thanks for watching.